Now it's killing me. Treasure Island? Treasure Island! What is wrong with me? Yeah, Treasure Island. Jeez. It's just a remake. Sand Kid 1. Underrated. Didn't do good at the box office at all. The Rocketeer.
Oh, yeah. That was so not you.
I love that movie.
Why?
I loved it.
It's so slow.
Oh, it just reminds me of
good old times, huh?
Reminds me of the whole Indiana Jones, World War II. Russians, spies, all the good stuff. I wish they'd gone more onto more of him doing more of the suit because they had to take the suit away from him. But what's his name? At the end of it, they left it open-ended because they had the suit. He had the plans for it.
Well, the poster was amazing. That alone, I thought it would be a lot better.
I had the helmet.
But it just came at a really bad time. Where is it?
I don't know. It was in storage.
But now, my ex-wife, above here is great.
My ex-wife, I think. She had it in storage. So my mom bought me the helmet. Because I used to be in the backyard with...
The original helmet?
From the like, when you bought toys, it was...
Wait, it came out in 1990.
She bought me the helmet. I was
when you were a senior in high school.
Yes.
Okay, just want to give perspective to everyone.
Come on, people!
Class president of his high school, go Crusaders, and he has this little Rocketeer over the place. Oh my goodness.
Underrated movies. It didn't do good in the box office. Bed knobs and broomsticks.
Ugh.
That you didn't you don't like that?
Mm-mm.
Yeah, you probably
imagine. Look at the little invitation. Yeah, I'm also one that doesn't like Mary Poppins.
First on for Pop, not Popkins, Mary Poppins.
Well, maybe it was Popkins, it would have done better.
Sheesh. Do you know what Bed Knobs and Broomsticks is about?
Something.
Do you even watch the movie?
No, I got bored.
Are you kidding me? The beginning part sets it up, and it just goes and takes off.
I never saw the beginning.
Okay, so...
I mean, for what it did at the time, but except Mary Poppins did it before.
So Bed Knobs and Broomsticks So when I was little, my uncle used to have a projector in the movie, watch movies. There's a scene that's a cartoon with a soccer scene, and I never knew what it came from. And it was from this movie, so that got me into it. But it's about... witchcraft. She wants to be a witch. She's learned how to do witchcraft, mm-hmm. so she can help win the war against the Nazis. Again, the Nazis are in it.
Because there's Nazis in there.
Disney puts Nazis in it. I'm surprised he didn't make them the heroes. Oh, no, I didn't go there.
Anyway, let's talk about another hero called Hercules, right? Hercules. Who did come out. I thought the music was amazing. But it was just very traditional, and I think a lot of kids didn't know who Hercules was.
I wasn't
right?
into it.
I know you didn't like that, but it couldn't compare. Remember, there was Beauty and the Beast, Lion King.
They came out at that time. They had Danny DeVito drawn to a key T, though.
Oh, true.
They had the goat he played looked just like him. No hair here, little pot belly. He looked like Danny DeVito. A movie you probably hate, and you guys got to watch it, The Black Hole.
Yeah.
I love it.
He always talks about
it.
Watched it.
I had the toy of the robot and the ship.
Where is the toy?
It was in my case, an older case I had from Star Wars, and I don't know, Mike's wife did something with it. She ate it or
Be
something.
Be careful who you settle down with, people.
My ex-wife ate it or something. I don't know what she did with it. She put it in there. Black Hole, amazing movie. We've got, what's his name from Psycho's in it? And Ernest Borgnine. You got Ernest Borgnine, the guy from Psycho. You got a winner movie there.
Now, are you a fan of Fantasia 2000 that was released in 1940?
Can I be honest?
I want you to lie throughout the whole podcast.
All right. And this is not my nerd side. This is my rocker side, I guess.
Your rocker?
Yeah, my rocker.
I've been to a Metallica concert. Right. AC/DC, I never hear you playing the radio.
All right.
I have.
Okay. I love Don't Fear the Reaper from Blue Oyster Cult. And that's rock music. I've seen Fantasia 2000 and the 41 only when I've been stoned. That's my rocker. Okay? So that's when I've seen it. And it's a great movie to watch when you're stoned.
And have you seen it when you've been not?
No, that movie's boring as hell. That's why you got to be stoned. All right. Do you want to do the final one? Did you like this final one, yes or no?
I never watched it, so you have to do it.
You've never seen Dumbo?
The live action? Nope.
Wow. It's good. Really good. I liked it.
Sees it without me.
I liked
it
a lot.
What a great partner.
What a great movie Dumbo was. Didn't do that well at the box office, what they expected, but I thought it did an amazing job. They more focused on the family part of it and relationships and somebody having a disability and relating to the elephant.
Well,
not weight-wise. Okay.
I mean, I think it's just the delivery of it. Colin Farrell's not, right? That was one of the lead actors. I mean, he's not as somebody to really attract people to see the movie. Like, oh my God, he's there.
Who's Colin Farrell?
He was the dad.
That's a joke.
Okay.
All right. So you didn't see the movie. You didn't like it at all.
Well, you never took me.
No. First off, you just said
Colin. I was in L.A. came out.
And you said Colin Farrell was in it, so you wouldn't like it at all. That's what you said.
No. He wasn't as popular at that time.
Okay.
To people to go watch the movie. That's my opinion. But you said you liked it.
They did good. I thought it was pretty good.
Oh, good for them.
Rosario Dawson. She's playing the new The Mandalorian.
Yeah, we mentioned it last time, but she's went public with it. So yeah. I think that's the big news right now.
And she also wants to talk about how she wants to join Star Trek Picard. If you want, we're not going to get into that. It's a whole other story.
Because he hasn't watched it. I watched it without him too.
Jesus,
I'm tired.
If you want to catch that,
I binged on that. It was really good.
You love Man with No Hair for some reason. What is this?
What the fuck? You're the one who dreams about them going into your bed. So I wouldn't talk about it. That's true.
I don't know what the hell she's talking about. Uh-huh. And then also I wanted to talk about this before we leave. Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D., the final season premiere date, it is announced. And they're going to have it's going to be on the May 27th. And they're going to have a crossover with that. Agent Carter is going to be on it.
Oh, what's been up with Agent Carter?
The ratings were gone bad.
No, so I know that. Yeah, well, it was getting, they were drawing it out.
It got to change. They had to change it because, well, they can't have the show now because Captain America went back in time.
No. But so. I'm just saying with the series, I mean, in the beginning it was great.
Oh, it was really good.
It was really good. And then I was like, what the fudge?
Did she marry the guy that was limping?
It gave you the impression. That is, I mean, we never really found out.
So Captain America went back in time.
That guy got screwed over so many ways.
So that guy was not only disabled, he got screwed over, and his kids weren't born, and probably the girl that, and this is what I read in an article, probably the girl that Captain America had the hots for, that she kissed in the car, and the she was probably never born.
Why? But that was her aunt. Yeah.
And she said she got into everything and everything she did, and she wouldn't be here today if it wasn't for her aunt.
Well, didn't mean her aunt would stop
her aunt working. Helped raise her and take care of her.
Well, you don't think they would do the same?
Not if you're married. Oh. She's with Captain America.
You're terrible.
You got to keep that guy straight.
Well, don't make you a godfather. Good Lord.
Also, Tron Legacy director offers fans who want a sequel some hope. How? They said there is a possibility, and they did have it green lit for a while, a third one, but they stopped after something happened. Some other movie bombed at the box office, and it wasn't that. Because Tron Legacy, although the critics didn't like it that well, a little slow, a little boring, I like the special effects, it did make its money. Oh, it made its money back well.
I thought you said that Tron Legacy didn't do that well.
It didn't do what they wanted, but it made its money back. See, what they want, you got to understand, Disney, they want Endgame money and they want Star Wars money. Solo movie made money, but he didn't make Star Wars money.
Thank God. So I don't want another one with that actor.
So if it's not that much money, it's like, well, what are we going to do this for?
But you know, it's interesting because the popularity on IMDb is basically showing like it's going down. There's not much interest. It had made a score of 49, and its rating compared to Star Trek and Star Wars is 6.8.
If you say so, I believe you.
Well, that's what it says.
I believe you.
IMDb. I mean, I don't make this
information. All right, anything you want to talk about that's happening in the world before we wrap up the show?
I think the main thing is make sure to be, you know, there's a lot of frontline workers out there being superheroes. Keep up the applause. But also at the same time, in order for you to become a superhero, take breaks, stretch out, talk to a neighbor with social distancing. How long did you talk to your neighbor for?
Today or yesterday?
Yesterday. Oh, and you did every day.
Oh, talk to her for like 20 minutes. Talk to her for 40 minutes. And the two gentlemen in the back, I forgot their names, they started talking to me.
Oh, my God.
They started talking to me.
Wow. Neighbors we've never talked to
before.
They're
all, do you want a drink? And then they dropped some pills into it. I didn't know what that, I was like, is that Alka-Seltzer?
And now you know why he dreams about bald men going into his bed. So with that saying, that's Fonseca.
I woke up 5 hours and they're like, you okay? And I'm like, yeah. And I had a big scar on the side of my appendix.
Hey, they're in shape. They look good. But anyway, I'm sorry. Hopefully it didn't hurt back there. But anyway, don't be a hero like that. But talk to a neighbor. Reach out. Social distancing. Don't sneeze on them.
Oh, my God. We got to wipe down all the board.
Clean yourself. And then until then, subscribe. Spotify. Spreaker. Apple Podcasts. TuneIn. And many more.
I'll talk to you guys next week. Make sure follow us on social media, please. Talk to you next week. Have a great, great, great week and be safe.
Sign off, everyone. Bye-bye.
Why does she always get the last word? So I'll say goodbye.
No. Don't forget to be a superhero to yourself and others.
All right. You guys have a great week.
You too, people. It was great to see you on a different platform too, everybody.
Bye.
Bye. Take care. Wow, adios. Ciao. Hasta la vista, baby.
Bye.
Ciao. So long. Farewell. Dun, 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 dun.
Hey, can you do this really fast?
Yes. Hi, this is George Newbern, and you're listening to Your Nerd Side. Your Nerd Side's on the air. This is George Newbern, and I listen to Your Nerd Side every week. I do. Hi, this is George Newbern and Fonseca. Fonseca? Hi, this is George Newbern and Fonseca and the crew. Wait, hold on. And the crew. Hi, this is George Newbern and Fonseca. And the crew. And the Fonseca and the crew? Is that one thing?
Okay. Fonseca and the crew.
Hi, this is George Newbern and Fonseca and the crew are on your nerd side.
You're perfect.
Hi, this is George Newbern. Have fun. Make fun of the show of Fonseca. Hi, my name is Jorge. Gracias de nada por su juicio, sí.